What good is an image if I can't restore my old backup to my new machine? Hi everyone, I'm Leo Notenboom for askleo.com, where this question comes up frequently. Before I go on, if you're watching this on YouTube, be sure and hit the subscribe button down below, and if at the end of the video you found it helpful, be sure and hit like. Both of those things will help other people find the answers that they're looking for on YouTube and will keep you up to date as I release new videos throughout the week. There's a rather lengthy question on the original article that this video is based on. I'm not going to read to you because I get it in so many different forms. It really does boil down to the title of the article. I've been backing up like you told me to, and now I've got a new machine. And you're telling me that I can't use my backups to just move everything to my new machine? No, that's exactly what I'm telling you. And here's the thing. That's not what backups are for. Backups are not for moving things to your new machine, at least not in the way you're trying to do it. Here's the problem. You've got your backups, an image backup, which has an image of everything on your machine. I love image backups because it has everything. There's no thinking involved. It's a copy of absolutely everything on your machine. And if, for example, on your existing machine, you replace a hard drive, image backups are perfect for that. Or if you get malware, image backups are perfect for that. You simply restore the image back to the machine that you took it from, maybe with a replaced hard drive, and you pick up where you left off. You have it returned to the state that the system was in when that image was taken. Now, what happens when you get a new machine? Well, consider the image backup is of Windows on your old machine. That means that Windows has been completely configured for the hardware and all of the nuances of the old machine. But you've got a new machine. You can try, I suppose, to restore the backup from the old machine as if it were the backup from the new machine. And things may or may not work. And that's because the new machine is different. It's different hardware. You've got different peripherals. You've got different configuration. And Windows setup didn't have a chance to run. Windows setup is all about configuring Windows to the nuances and characteristics of the machine it's being set up on. By trying to restore a backup from one machine onto a completely different machine, you're bypassing that completely. Now, Windows will try, Lord knows it will try really, really hard to configure and reconfigure and change things on the fly when it notices that hardware changes. This is a massive change. Everything underneath Windows will have changed. Instead, what it will do is it will try to change everything. You have three possibilities, three possible outcomes. One, it won't work. It just won't boot. Things are just way too different. It's not going to work. Number two is things are going to work kind of. You'll notice right away that, you know, this isn't working right, or that's stumbling, or this is really slow, or any number of things are going to be pretty obvious pretty quick. It'll kind of sort of look like it's working, but it'll be pretty obvious that it's not. The third option is actually the scariest, and that's the option where it looks like it's working. It just does. Everything looks like it's working. You have no guarantee that you haven't set yourself up for a catastrophic failure in the future. There's a really good chance that, in fact, there is something underneath the hood that you just haven't exercised yet that actually hasn't ported over from the old to the new machine, is not configured correctly because Windows setup didn't have a chance to run. The machine basically looks like it works, but it's a trap. It's not going to at some point. My recommendation, and in fact, the only real solution for moving to a new machine, is that you let Windows setup do its thing. You install Windows on the new machine. Then you install your applications on the new machine. And then you install or copy over your data to the new machine. That's where your image backup comes in handy again. You don't restore the entire image to your new machine, but rather, after your new machine is set up, after you have Windows running, after you have your applications installed, then you can mount the image and copy your data files from the image backup to your new machine. It's perfect for that. It's a catch-all. In fact, you don't even have to worry if you saved everything that you needed to save from the old machine, because you've got everything that was on the old machine in your backup image. Even if it's some random and obscure file you didn't realize you were going to need, it's in the image. You can find it, you can copy it, you can do whatever is necessary. So that's how your image backup gets used when you're using a new machine. It's not a way to transfer everything to the new machine, but it can be a way to transfer your data to the new machine. Now, there are some scenarios that I at least have to acknowledge, and that is there are tools that will claim to solve the problem. In fact, Macrium Reflect, one of my recommended backup tools, has a feature they call redeploy, which is pretty much exactly what you're asking for or what you're thinking of. It is a technique that allows them to account for all the changes that happen when you try and restore an image to a completely different machine. It's not just restoring the image. Redeploy makes a number of the other changes that are necessary for that image to work. I've used it once and it worked okay. I restored a Vista image to one of my virtual machines that I now use. It actually did a fairly adequate job. It was a completely different machine and there were still some issues left over, but they were the kinds of issues that you would expect. For example, the old machine had a printer, the virtual machine did not. The old machine had another piece of hardware, the virtual machine did not. Those are big, those are obvious. I felt relatively confident that there weren't any lurking issues underneath the hood. But those are the kinds of things that these tools try to fix. And as wonderful as I think Reflect is, and as wonderful as I suspect Redeploy is, honestly, it's still not something I would rely on for moving my primary machine, my production machine, from one piece of hardware to another. That is an opportunity to reinstall from scratch. And honestly, I believe that reinstalling from scratch, reinstalling your applications from scratch, and then copying over your data will get you the most stable long-term system than any other alternative. And certainly, simply restoring an image backup to a new machine, it's not going to get you that. For the article on which this little rant was based, for related links, for comments, for any updates, visit askleo.com/3963. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.